Okay. Hi. I'm Tony Danza, and I'm live in New York City. Come on, boys, let's go. Come on.
Tony's guests today are Everybody Loves Raymond star Ray Romano, Food Network's Rachael Ray makes chicken cacciatore ravioli stew, from the ABC sitcom Hope and Faith, Ted McGinley, and Survivor Vanuatu's first casualty, Brooke Garrity. And here's your host, Tony Danza.
This way. Come on. 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 Oh, don't get scared. Okay? Easy. Oh, God, God. I can't do it. Oh, Prince. Don't worry, they're all safe. They had me down. I was down outside. Here. Taylor. Hi, Taylor. Good boy, yes. Audience members think they get dogs now. Here. Okay. I never worked so hard in my life. Come on, sweetheart. Oh, wait, Mac. No, you. This dog wants to be in the show. Come on, sweetheart. All right, here we go. That was work. Look at me. I don't know how, you know, in New York, look, first of all, I got 82 bags just in case. You know, you want to clean up. How do they do that? You know, we see people in New York every day. I see, that was the, whose bright idea was that? Oh, it was that, but you see the people in New York, they're walking dogs like this. These guys do very well, and I figured maybe I'd try it, but no. Oh, good morning, everyone. How are you? Nice to see you. Oh, wow. It's Monday, September 20th, 2004, the beginning of our second week. We're so excited. It's really, thank you. Thank you. Oh. Thank you for being here, and thank you all for being here. Thank you for tuning in at home. Say hello to the best. The best Ed McMahon since Ed McMahon. Ladies and gentlemen, Erica Bettini. I'm exhausted. I was outside. They pulled me right down on the ground. It was unbelievable.
How do you smell?
And then they got into a fight, and I have a little bit of an odor. How are you, Bettini?
I'm
okay?
Good. Yeah.
Yeah. How was your weekend?
Out. Awesome. I had friends in town, and we went dancing.
Really?
Yeah.
Went clubbing?
I know. I don't do that very often anymore,
but it was fun. It was a beautiful weekend. You know, it's fall, obviously, and I'm sure it's beautiful all over the country, but it is exceptionally beautiful in New York. And I went to the park yesterday, mm-hmm. read the paper. Oh, by the way, I was sitting on a bench. In Central Park on a beautiful, beautiful Sunday afternoon, and you know, the place is just, it's magnificent to see all the people and everybody getting along in this beautiful park, and people were coming up to me saying how much they love the show. We love the show. Hey, it was a great show. Great first week, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Then one lady came up to me and said, hey, love the show, but lose the accent.
What?
That's going to be tough for me. Yeah. So other than that, it was great. Great sports weekend this weekend. I don't know if you know. Of course, I forgot to mention this on Monday. I also forgot to mention Happy New Year. But anyway, no, actually, I mentioned it, but it was in a post tape, so it'll run like close to the next holiday. Anyway, great sports weekend. You know, the Yankees and the Red Sox. Yankees took 2 out of 3. Well, that's good for us. Not so good for Boston, I understand. And the Giants and the Jets won yesterday, so it was a great week. You know who I like? I really like. I think he's the best player of baseball. Derek Jeter.
Oh,
really good. Oh, he's unbelievable. You know, have to admit something. You know, I write him notes. I just write. He never writes me back, but I write him notes. I don't know if he gets them, but I write him all these notes, like, you know.
He's a cutie guy.
Yeah, he's a cutie.
I think the ladies like him, too, but for other reasons.
Really?
He's a cutie.
Is that so? a lot of TV Saturday. I stayed in because I had a, you see the...
What were you watching?
Well, I was flipping back and forth from Miss America, hi, to Oscar De La Hoya. It was unbelievable. It was crazy. After a while, I lost track which was the most competitive. I think the women was quite a thing, Miss America pageant. They changed it, you know. No more...
No more what?
They don't have... the talent contest is down to two. They changed it to a reality show.
Was.
They changed the Miss America pageant into a reality show. I'm not so sure I like it. I mean it, too. And I thought I sang that song better than Clay Aiken, too. That's another thing. No, I didn't. Not really. We're going to have... Miss America's going to be here tomorrow, I think. Yeah, tomorrow. Deidre Downs is her name. And, you know, it was interesting. There was a weird juxtaposition because I was watching Trio. That's a channel that has all those old shows on it. It had the 1958 Miss America pageant on. Quite a different little occasion. It was really something. Marianne Mobley won, by the way.
Wow.
For those of you who keep track of that, yeah. And this is the 50th anniversary of the pageant, I think, isn't it?
Is it really?
Or it's the 50th anniversary of somebody. Lee Merriweather, right? It's Lee Merriweather, her 50th anniversary, yeah. What else? Did you watch the Emmys?
I did watch the Emmys.
You know, you got fired again on TV.
I turned it on late, and the first thing I saw was my face up there, again, being fired.
And fired just horribly,
I know,
too.
I mean, he really rubs. I mean, it's really a nightmare.
He rubs your nose in it, you know.
Yes.
You didn't do this, you didn't do that. Erica, don't say it, Mr. Trump. So funny.
Let me tell you something. That was a whisper, I swear to God. I don't even think he heard that the first time.
What? Because
I said, don't
say it, Mr. Trump.
Yeah.
Oh, no, trust me, he heard it.
Well, now everybody's heard it.
And then the Emmys. Everybody watched the Emmys? That was kind of fun.
Yeah.
I was glad for The Sopranos because they've been very good to us. They've been helping us with the show. Tony Sirico and Steve Schripper, and of course, James Gandolfini, who, by the way, did you see this? They were cutting people off with the music. And I guess he wanted to say something to somebody when they won the Emmy, you know. And I T-voted it because I went back and I tried to read his lips, you know, trying to say, who's he thanking? So if you're out there, James, and I know you are my booker, and I've already taken, you know, advantage of you. So if you you want to come on and, you know, thank somebody, you could come here and do it.
Nice.
We'll have it easy. No problem. I'm telling you, I'm exhausted from the dog thing, man. I was outside 10 seconds and then I was down. I was like, oh, my God. Do you know what else? I watched last week, I watched Survivor. I like that. Vanuatu, which, remember, is here, Pat Sajak, too.
Bad.
You know, yeah, but John Redman likes that joke, so it's okay. But anyway, we have today Brooke Garrity from in the audience. Do I not? He's mic'd, I guess. Let me go over. Brooke.
Oh, my God, Brooke.
Brooke, how are you, Brooke? Nice to see you.
How you doing?
Now, Brooke Garrity, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Brooke, I mean, in a way, they probably should have just voted you up on the airplane. Right? That would have been easier. Because you really you didn't get to do anything.
Yeah.
And what's funny is the other guy, the other guy, Chris, was the guy who blew it. But they got rid of you. Why do you think they did that? You were imposing and big strapping fellow.
That's why I like Survivor. You know, if it was an athletic event, obviously I'd still be there most likely, and Chris would be gone. But Survivor's got nothing to do with you know, being an athlete, and actually being an athlete and being strong is hurts you in the game of Survivor.
Yeah, because they want to get rid of you. Did you have a few fights?
Not really. No,
I just see your nose. It looks like
really.
Yeah.
No, what about you?
Well, yeah,
you look like you had a few more than I have. Maybe a couple hockey talks.
Well, listen, here's what we want to do. Since you didn't get to do a challenge, we have a little challenge for you.
Awesome.
And if you can do this challenge, everybody in the audience will win something, and you'll get a great prize,
cool.
Okay?
Let's
so you're up for it?
Let's go.
It's right outside. Now, there we go. Now, here's the idea. We have, it's one of these survivor-like challenges. We have a stump outside, And Brooke has to stand on the stump and have a bamboo pole on his ear. He's setting it up right now. And we have water buckets on the ends, and we'll be adding water through the whole show. And he has to stay there until his segment.
Look how he's huge.
Yeah, but he's huge. Look at him. Look at him. You know, you never know what you might see on the streets of New York, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, and now, you know what time it is, Petrini?
Oh, I know.
Petrini, it's time for our favorite game of the day. It's when we give a chance, a home viewer a chance, to win up to $5,000 from our friends at Disney's Visa. And the way they win is they have to answer a question about a subject they told us they were an expert in. It's a little game we like to call Extravaganza. Okay, on the phone today, we have Kim Howen from Houston, Texas, who watches us on KTRK Channel 13. Kim, are you there?
Good morning, Tony.
Hi, Kim. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm really well. Thank you. Thanks for being here. You know, so how's Houston?
It's hot.
Yeah.
It's very hot.
Well, you know, we did some city-specific promos where we went to Houston, and I was really impressed about how people were so proud of the city. It's really a great little, it's a great city. So anyway, what do you do there?
I work for Continental Airlines.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yes, and I'm so glad that you're back on TV. I've missed you, Tony.
Oh, thank you. We're gonna send you the extra 10 in the mail. Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Anyway, so what is it that you claim to be an expert in, Kim?
Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind.
It's a wonderful movie, very epic movie.
Uh huh.
Yeah, it's great.
So how many times have you seen it, may I ask?
Oh, about 15.
15. Okay, we're gonna put you to the test.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you one question about Gone with the Wind.
Okay.
You'll have a chance to win anywhere from $1,000 to the grand prize of $5,000. Take it away, Petrini.
You got it, Kim. I'm going to pick you a number from 1 to 5. So we got here 3, Kim.
Okay.
I want to get you $5,000.
All right, the middle.
Come on.
All right, the middle. Get out of here. Get it out.
2,000.
Ooh. All right.
Not bad. 2,000.
All right, Kim. So you'll be playing for $2,000 on a Disney Visa gift card.
Okay.
You get 15 seconds on the clock and only one guess. The clock starts when I'm finished reading the question. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, put 15 seconds on the clock. Here we go. Now, a cast member from Gone with the Wind appeared in 3 films in 1939 that were all nominated for Best Picture. Who was it?
Olivia de Havilland?
Oh, no, I'm so sorry. Its name actually was Thomas Mitchell, who played Vivian Leigh, Scarlett's father, in the picture. So well, you said you were an expert, so you know.
Yeah, really, I didn't really think it.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy, you know. But we're going to send you a $100 gift certificate from Bed Bath & Beyond, and we thank you for being part of Extravaganza. Thank you so much for being on the show, Kim. I appreciate it. She's gone. Now, if you know a lot about a certain subject, and I'm new at this. What do you want from me? Oh, silly. So if you know a lot about a certain any subject, I don't care how obscure it is, you want the chance to win up to $5,000, go to our website. Tell me about it. Tell me what subject it is, and I promise I'll give you a chance to win other people's money. All right, yeah, we got a great show for you today, ladies and gentlemen. Ray Romano is here. I'll be in the kitchen with Rachael Ray making chicken cacciatore ravioli stew. And from Hope and Faith, one of the good guys around, Ted McGinley, is here. And later, we'll see how our survivor, Brooke Garrity's doing on the Danza Challenge. So don't go away, folks. All right.
Next, Tony and Ray Romano hit the streets and race to the finish in the very first sitcom 500. Later, he was first to be voted off the island. But will Brooke survive the Danza Challenge?
How you doing, Brooke?
How you doing in there?
All right, Brooke. Hang in there, baby.
I'm gonna
right,
get
so
you
love
those
them.
Prizes.
What's that, Brooke?
I got it taken care of. So I'm gonna get the audience those prizes.
All right, good.
Don't worry about it. I'm gonna tell you.
They're gonna miss him on Survivor, I'm telling you. You love him. I love him. In fact, everybody loves our first guest. His hit show, Everybody Loves Raymond, kicks off its nine years, and final season tonight. Take a look at this classic scene.
Now, here's where my mom and dad live. So anything within this circle is too close to my parents' house.
Would you put that away? They're going to be here any minute.
You're not listening. If my mom can cook sauce and get it to our house before it's cold, she's going to be over every day. We'll call this the hot zone.
I like her sauce.
Let me finish, please. Now, anything within this zone is going to be about a once-a-week visit. Okay, now here, farthest away, best zone, right? Wrong! Because if we move here and they visit, they become overnight guests.
Please welcome Ray Romano. It's a classic.
Pregnant.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh.
Get out.
So that's a classic scene. Is that from the first
season?
That's
from season one, man.
Well, that's the thing, you know, because we know the videotape thing here.
Yeah, that's what's bad about it. You get to see more hair, more whatever.
Yeah, you know, I tell you something, Ray, just as a side thing, I know when I did a show, I'd watch it. It was like a man in search of a hairdo. That's what the whole thing was. You know?
Yeah, but you always have it, though.
Well, thanks very much.
But Patty's pregnant. I don't know if you saw in that clip. She's pregnant in that episode. In real life.
In real life.
We're hiding it, you know.
Not well.
No, but she was pregnant two of the first 3 years. Yeah, I had nothing.
Not in the contract.
Yeah, right.
So you look in shape. You look tan. Yeah.
I've been at Malibu. Your stomping ground.
Yeah, well, I haven't been out there in a while.
Yeah, we rented a house in Malibu. I'm a boogie boarder. Are you? Yeah. Why are you laughing? I would be laughing at that.
Actually, I do it a little bit myself.
I used to surf. Do you surf?
I surf a little bit.
You grew up here.
Laird Hamilton.
You grew up here.
I did it a little bit in Montauk when I was a kid.
I did it at Rockaway Beach. I learned to surf in Queens, and then I moved to California. I don't surf anymore. Well, I'm at the age where I want to do any sport where I can just lay down and pee at the same time. Can't get hurt, and I don't have to go to the bathroom.
That's some sport. Anyway, so... Speaking of peeing, we got kids together in school, right? Ray has two twins, Matt and Greg, and my daughter Emily. They're in the same class. And I think I got to worry about one of those two twins. I think there's something.
It's Matthew. He got a crush on Emily Danza.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be a big Italian wedding. There'll be a lot of chicken dances and the train. You know, you go to these Italian weddings, if you step on the dance floor, you're going to get sucked into something. The train always gets me. You know what I'm talking about, right? The human idiot. Because you don't see it. Can I stand?
Yeah, please.
You don't see it. What happens to me is it grabs you by surprise. You're like, I'm going to the men's room. I'll see you in 1 second. Yeah. What? Oh, geez. Yeah, you're on a thing.
I think so. Now... We also have in common that we're Italian.
Yeah.
You know, and I have Italians. I have Erica Vitrini on the show, a Vitrini Italian. My piano player's Nadia Di Gelinardo. It's not like I wanted everybody to be Italian, but it just worked out that way.
And they're in the union.
And they're in the union. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you grew up in a typical Italian house, right?
Well, how typical was yours? Did you the plastic and the thing and the furniture is covered? And
we had that originally, but then they got very progressive and they took the plastic off.
You grew up in Brooklyn?
In Brooklyn.
Yeah.
In East New York. And I also ended up in 1965, we moved to Malvern, Long Island, and I went to high school in Malvern.
Yeah. Well, I had the plastic. I mean, everything in my house was the furniture. You can't sit on the towels in the bathroom. You can't touch towels.
Those are the ones with the monogram.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. But as a little kid, you come out of the shower, don't touch. You're like, I'm cold. Mommy. Yeah. Everything is, there's china you can't use.
It's display.
Yes.
It's in the hutch.
In the hutch. Everything for it's all for a special occasion that never happens. Nobody comes over. And now my wife, she designed the house. We live in,
it's a beautiful house. It's like an Italian villa. It's really spectacular.
Right,
really,
but it's too much for me. I don't need that much, but, I'll let her do her thing. But we got the formal dining room.
Yes.
Do you have one in your house?
Got to have a formal dining room.
When do you use it? Do you use it? Seriously, 3 years, I've been in it once.
It's me too, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. The living room has become that too. I don't think you go in the living room as much.
That's the thing.
Why do they call it a living room?
No, I wouldn't mind. Okay, I'll give my wife the formal living room, whatever it is. If the informal one, I can't even move in that one, you know? If I have a pickle, an alarm goes off, you know?
I love that joke from your show, a pickle is a drink and a vegetable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Speaking of Anna, how is your wife, Anna? How's she doing? My wife said to say hello, by the way.
Yeah, she's very good.
Is she here in New York?
No, she's coming in. The kids had the first day of school.
I know.
So she's coming in. And we're good. You know, we have our little, like anybody, we have our little arguments.
Oh, really?
You know? Yeah, oh, really. Yeah. Oh, really. Yeah. Yeah, we had one the other night. Well, first of all, we were watching the show. And once in a while I can get her to watch my show. And we were watching it, and she watched a scene between me and Patty Heaton.
Right.
And she looks at me and she goes, "You just talked to her in that scene more than you've talked to me this whole week." Right. But I told her, I go, "Well, we have writers on the show." Yeah. If there were writers,
that's the key.
I run out.
That's the key to marriage. You need writers.
You need
a couple
writers to keep the conversation going.
So, you know, I'm a little I'm sad about the show. I don't know how you feel. It must be an interest. I mean, 9 years doing something, seeing people every day and devoting yourself to something, and it changes your life.
Well, my life has changed since the beginning of the show, but it's also, you're right. The last 9 years, all my energy has been devoted to this, all my creative energy, whatever. And it hasn't hit yet because we're still in the beginning of the season. But once we start counting down and getting closer, there's going to be a void.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lot of emotion, you know, excitement, sadness, chagrin. I'm sure chagrin.
Chagrin will be there,
be in there.
Yeah, you know, you start doing, this is the last time I'll ever do this.
Yeah, we started that.
Yeah.
We started the first table read. This is the last first table
read. Exactly.
Yeah. Been through this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been great, though, Ray. I mean, it's, I remember the first time I saw it, I just... You know, I said, oh, this is finally really a good sitcom. I mean, something that appeals to a broad audience.
Really
great show.
Yeah.
Really great show.
All right, look. And good luck with this show. You're doing great.
Oh, thank you very much. And look, we got other things, too. Look, Everybody Loves Raymond family album. Right? And don't forget the DVD. Now, wait a minute. Now, hold on. Don't go away, because when we come back, Ray and I are going to go mano a Romano. In tiny race cars. What do you see? This is the sitcom 500. Stay with us.
I'm a little drunk. Are you sure we can?
Yeah, we'll be all right.
Later, Food Network's Rachael Ray shows you how to whip up a kid-friendly Italian stew in 30 minutes or less. Still to come? Find out if Brooke, Survivor's first castaway, survives the Danza Challenge.
Coming up on the next Tony Danza Show, looking for the fountain of youth, this popular actress says she's found the perfect recipe in our kitchen, Suzanne Summers. Also, he's gone from playing the arch-villain in Spider-Man 2 to playing one of Broadway's most memorable roles. From Fiddler on the Roof, my friend Alfred Molina. Plus, we'll meet the newest Miss America. And another lucky viewer gets a chance to win $5,000 as we play my favorite game, Extravaganza. Please don't miss the next Tony Danza Show. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at the Sitcom 500. If you take a little look at the course, you'll see we have sitcom people's heads. Okay. Now, here's the deal. We're playing. Ray brought a bunch of these DVDs, but only enough for half the audience. So Ray's playing for the left side of the audience, and I'm playing for the right side of the audience. We'll see who wins, okay? Okay. Mano a Romano. Oh, okay, Natalie Wood, get out there.
Hey, I'm
Drop
ready.
That flag.
Get your engine
Wait
started.
A minute. Hold what? On.
Let's go. I'm ready.
Engine I need a started. Rosary bead.
Ready, set, go.
Oh, bad jump. Bad jump. You jumped the gun.
Oh, God.
Who's on the snap?
So.
Somebody push me. Go. Yeah. God.
So, you know,
I pulled a groin, Ray, and a neck, Ray, in the same shot.
It's not bumper cars, Ray. Hey, guess what? Everybody gets one. How's that? Ray got a neck.
That's scary. That's so scary right there.
Thanks for doing the show.
Is that you hitting me?
Next, chicken cacciatore ravioli stew in 30 minutes or less with Food Network star Rachael Ray. Tomorrow, Suzanne Summers shows Tony how to summer-size.
Poor Brooke. Go ahead, Brooke. Brooke, hang in there, Brooke.
My back's killing me, Tony.
Don't worry, Brooke. You'll be fine. Thanks to our friends at HBO Video for the first season of Everybody Loves Raymond DVDs. Now, the other night, I ordered takeout, and they said it would take 45 minutes. Now, that's crazy, because our next guest says you can make a delicious dinner at home in 30 minutes. She's here to teach us how to make chicken cacciatore ravioli stew. Please welcome the host of the Food Network's 30-Minute Meals, Rachael Ray. Hey, Rach.
How you doing?
I'm great. How about yourself?
I am always doing well, but I am so thrilled to be here. Aww. You are just such a rock star.
Well,
I'm
thank
so
you.
Happy. No, everybody gets to sing.
I just did your show, right?
I have a new show on the Food Network this fall called Inside Dish, and I dish beautiful celebrities such as yourself, and you took me to Frankie.
I took you to the official Italian restaurant in Los Angeles of the Tony Danza show,
so
Frankie's on Melrose.
Frankie's on Melrose.
Used to be Maddie's, used to be before that Johnny's. It was the whole thing.
I'm telling you, I can't tell you. It's one of my favorite nights of my life. He sang to me. We ate great food. The owner, oh my God.
You know, he had a couple of drinks. I start singing. Anyway, tell everyone about the small chef big mess challenge.
Isn't this awesome?
I like this.
I teamed up with all laundry detergents this year, and we did this huge cooking contest, coast to coast, kids 6 to 12 years old. I was working on a new kid's book. They were working on all these tips to get kids into the kitchen to cook with their families because, of course, all gets out stains,
right,
and they make messes in the kitchen. Right. So we teamed up, and I got to tell you, the contest was a huge hit. All these kids wrote in their messiest recipes, and the 25 finalists now are on all-laundry.com, and everybody in America can vote for the winner, who's going to win $25,000 college scholarship money. Plus, they're going to cook with me and you.
They're going to come on the show.
They're going to come on the show in November and cook with me and you.
All right, because I like this idea. The only thing I'm worried about is the biggest mess may be that the house burned down. But anyway.
Exactly.
Let's get started. Let's start later.
Okay, now this is a recipe that I designed for kids. It's in my new kids' cookbook. I brought you the very first copy.
I know. Now, this doesn't come out for a few weeks yet?
Comes out beginning of October. It just came off the press. This is the only copy you have it.
All right.
Yeah, it's for you and your kids. Now, what I like about this book is that it's food everybody would eat. I need you to whack some garlic there. Break off some garlic. Give it a good whack. And okay. I'm getting a pot hot here. I'm going to put a little EVOO in it. And this is an easy...
Extra virgin olive oil.
Exactly. It's an easy supper that the kids can make totally on their own, or you can make it together. Do you cook with your kids?
Yes, I do.
See?
I love cooking.
Don't you think it's so good for the kids? Just give it to me crushed. It'll break up.
Yeah, I just want to get the skin off.
Yeah, all right. Well, you got to give it a good whack.
Now slice up
a couple of mushrooms. Don't cheat. Now, that's for kids. Now, if the kids are making this, you buy the pre-sliced mushrooms.
Yeah, watch. Here goes a finger.
Look at you. You're having a very tough time.
Okay, here we go.
All right, I'll let you cheat.
How much you want?
Throw in that whole thing.
All right, there we go.
Now, this is some defrosted spinach. I want you to squish it out over the garbage bowl there.
Squish it out?
Yeah, it's always good when you're cooking. When you're cooking, it's always awesome, of course, to have a garbage bowl, so you don't have to waste time running back and forth to the garbage can, right?
All right.
And then we put in lots of fresh herbs. You just throw everything right in the pot as you get it.
All right, it's ready.
Just throw it all in there.
Okay.
So you got spinach, you got mushrooms. I put in a couple of stems each of rosemary and get us some fresh thyme.
Okay,
now
some thyme.
When it boils up, you see what happens. Look. It boils right off and into the soup, so you don't need to chop or pull it off. It's a soup. It falls off.
Okay.
The heat does the work for you.
It makes a great flavor.
Exactly. Okay. And then you take store-bought stock. You get this in boxes, paper boxes.
Okay.
On the soup box.
How much of that?
6 cups.
All right.
So you buy one big box, 2 little boxes. And then you just let that come up to a bubble, and then when it comes up to a bubble, you add some roasted red peppers.
Ooh,
put
I like
some of
that.
Those in. You made this in like 2 seconds,
yeah, this
I'd
is
like
great.
To say.
This is some tomato.
Some tomato sauce. Sure. About a cup.
Oh, like I
cup,
said.
Cup and a half.
And then these are?
Chopped stewed tomatoes. They're already chopped in a can with vegetables, so the kids just open the cans and add the stuff. You see? It's not about kids making the mess. It's
I turned my finger. What do you want me?
Oh, you poor baby.
Where's the wooden spoon?
Where's the big you got plastic.
We
I know at home
spoon.
It's always wooden, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you let that come up to a boil, then you just add your ravioli and your chicken, and it comes out like this.
Oh, man.
And then also from the book, this is such a cute recipe. Kids love this. You take a thin crust pizza, like a boboli, you cut the circles, you put a little pizza sauce on it, and you make hamburgers that taste like little meatballs.
Uh-huh.
How cute. And then you
Look,
pop
I'm
them in the oven,
here.
And
I
you put a little provolone and pepperoni on it, and they're little individual pieces. But this is all really healthy food. If you get the kids in the kitchen with you, they can learn, you know, everything from sharing, you know, to basics of math.
Yeah, not only that, they don't have to cook for themselves. They
right.
can do it.
And it's an activity that means something to them.
We have a
an official taster.
Audrey, come on over.
Come on in, Audrey.
Hi, Audrey. Audrey, what's your last name? All right, Audrey, have a taste of that.
Have some ravioli stew.
Have a taste of that.
Here, this food's for you.
Yeah, I need a four.
And I get some, too.
All right.
It's good, right? And a little kid can make that.
We made that in a minute, and it's so great. The bookstore's in October. Cooking Rock, Rachael Ray, 30-minute meals for kids. Thank you, Rachael.
Home-laundry.com. Vote for the kids.
Oh, yeah, don't forget that.
Because we're going to cook
together. Yeah. Messy kids, we like it. Thanks, Rich.
Thank you. Let's
Look, we'll be right back.
How's it going?
Good.
How's it going? Yeah.
Next, from Happy Days to Hope and Faith, actor Ted McGinley. Later, he was kicked off the island, but will Survivor's first cast off win the Danza Challenge?
Brooke, you're unbelievable, Brooke. You're hanging in,
thanks,
huh?
Thanks, Hey, am I getting a prize for this, too? What's up?
Yeah. Well, we'll see how
audience.
You do. We'll see how you do.
Cool.
Anyway,
cool.
Hey, look, Rachael Ray's book. Signed it for me, huh? Okay, don't forget it. Oh, God. Let's see. You know, our next guest, you know him from some of the biggest shows on television, including Happy Days, The Love Boat, Married with Children, and Dynasty, just to name a few. Here he is in his latest show, Hope and Faith.
The best, most wonderful, most not angry daddy in the whole wide world is home.
Where is she?
She's right here. I'm back. Oh, darling, I know you're happy to see me. I can't breathe out.
Please welcome one of the good guys around, Ted McGinley.
Hey,
please have a seat.
All right.
Hey, take that book.
Woo! Wow, this is fantastic.
Huh? You like my set?
What a set.
You like my set? See, look, the bridge. The Brooklyn Bridge.
Really? Now, where did you live from there?
I lived over there.
Speaking of
it. Or over there.
The other side.
One side or the other.
I brought Tony the shirt.
Man. Thank you.
Yeah. I got it at the street fair.
Yeah, yesterday it was a street fair on Columbus Avenue,
right?
Yeah,
it cost me $2.
Oh, thanks.
That's right. So,
well, you know, guys from Brooklyn never buy themselves a Brooklyn shirt.
That's exactly
think, you know,
something you'd never want to be seen buying, but I thought you should have it.
I will wear this in pride.
Yes,
I will.
Well,
thank
I'll
you.
Watch every week just to make
thank
sure.
Well, I don't know if I'm going to wear it on the show. Take it
Why,
easy.
Don't you think you should wear it on the show? What's wrong with that?
Speaking of shows, you've been on a lot of shows.
Yeah, I'm your worst nightmare.
What do you mean?
You know, I've been really fortunate.
Yeah, but on some of the greats.
But, you know, I can't take credit for any shows because I was never there from the beginning.
Oh, I see.
So people say, you're so lucky to have been on the show. Yeah, I was lucky to be on the show. But I'd like to be on one from the very beginning and see it all the way through to the end.
Well, you hope and faith.
Hopefully this is it.
You got hope that hope and faith will be that one.
Yeah, Kelly Ripa's like, wait a minute, aren't you the guy from Jump the Shark? You're on our show?
Do you know what Jump the Shark is, folks? Jump the Shark is when a show has gone over the edge.
It is a website dedicated to the fact that whenever I come on the show, it ruins the show. So, well, sorry, Tony.
I don't believe that. How's that? I will buck that trend.
All right, now.
So you were in one of the great shows of all time, Happy Days. You know, I love that show because when I got to Hollywood, they were, you know, they were right next door at Paramount.
Right. And And you were so famous. You know, Tony's one of these guys bigger than life, and he was on the Paramount lot, and I was so excited to meet you for the first time. I'll never forget that. And you came up and gave me a big kiss right on the face. I thought, oh, my God, what was that? Tony Danza just kissed me on the face, but because I grew up in this very waspy family where I didn't even kiss my mom on the face.
I was happy to see you. I gave you, you know, like it's an Italian thing.
I know, and then I thought maybe it was a hit.
I mean,
something.
We didn't make out already.
You know, no, I thought you. You know,
oh, you
I
mean
was
you thought?
Be, yeah.
Yeah. Don't
you know,
forget
I had
the
no
cannoli.
Idea.
Yeah.
But you, and then I, you know, you were when we did Married with Children. You guys were doing Who's the Boss?
We're right next door to one another.
And
right?
Everybody, all the girls kept saying, "Oh, Tony Danza.
No,
oh,
please,
he's so hot."
Give me a break.
And then you know, I moved out to the beach, and of course, Tony has a house at the beach. All the girls are hanging around his house.
Oh, get out of here. I'm married a long time. My wife will hang me.
No.
Wait a minute. So did they just have a reunion, a Happy Days reunion?
We just had a reunion.
When was it? I didn't get my invitation.
Well, you were getting ready to start your show.
Yeah, I think I was here. That's
no, but I told Henry Winkler. It turned out it's going to be an ABC special.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh.
And
I was at the one they didn't film. Yeah,
yeah, I remember.
Yeah.
But, you know, Tony's a great pitcher, for those of you who don't know, softball pitcher. And Henry Winkler is the other pitcher on the other team. So since you didn't show up, Gary Marshall, who created Happy Days and Taxi, was the pitcher this time.
Oh, well.
Everybody was there. It was a great deal. We played softball, and I flew in because I'm here through the week, and then I fly home on the weekends if I can.
Now,
are you doing that?
I am to some degree, yes.
It's a tough deal, isn't it?
It makes it hard.
But
it
you
does.
Fly first class probably back and forth, don't you?
Well,
No. I'm JetBlue, and...
Well,
I'm Mr. JetBlue. They call me Mr. JetBlue. But the great thing is...
I'm starting to feel real bad for you. You ruin shows and fly JetBlue. Yeah. It's amazing.
I know. It's not good.
Nah, you're okay. How's the wife and kids? Everybody, the family's good, I hope?
They're still talking to me.
That's good.
My kids just started school as well. I have two boys, 10 and 7. And
what great ages those are.
The best.
It must be great.
Truly. And my wife, I love my wife so much because she's doing all the work while I'm here in New York. Living it up, so I have to thank Gigi.
Gigi, thanks a lot.
Yeah.
So do you remember, you know, we go back, and we've done some of the great shows on TV, including Battle of the Network Stars.
Yeah.
Remember, I was the captain of the team, and we were the ABC gang. And
that's right. And you were a natural around the ocean in those days.
Oh,
remember?
Yeah, well, I was, yeah. Well, I had a but you were a great runner. You were the runner of
No, you thought I was the runner.
Well,
turned
you
out I was the slowest guy
on
the team.
Look at him. He looks like an athlete. You go, he's going to be fast. No.
I was okay.
Show the clip. Let's show you.
Oh,
this
no.
is Ted burning up the course. Oh, no.
Oh!
They went right to my
that
clip.
That looks like me, but actually this is you showing some of your prowess in
well,
the water.
Well, this was a relay that they had.
We were way in the lead.
We were way in the lead, and then... I got one.
Yeah. Yeah, man, you were a natural in the water.
Yeah, and then look,
there.
Here I am again getting washed back in.
Now, we were way in the lead when Tony comes up.
Yeah.
And there's our captain right there.
Well, I don't want to say anything, but a monsoon picked up just as I got in the water.
Yeah. Oh, that's funny.
You know, that's really the hard thing about cable. They find stuff like that.
That's exactly right.
That's on the Trio network.
You know what, though? You look better now than you did then.
Oh, thanks, Ted. You're all right.
I mean that. Thank you.
Ted, thank you so much for being here. Hope and Faith is on Friday night. The premiere September 24th at 9 p.m. on ABC. And one of the good guys around. Watch the show. We'll be right back. Look at him. Our next guest barely got his feet wet on the island of Vanuatu before becoming the first castaway to be voted off this season's Survivor. Take a look.
First person voted out of Survivor Vanuatu Island of Fire. Brooke, need to bring your torch.
All right, now look, there he is. He's made it to his segment, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Survivor Castaway, Brooke Garrity. Come on in, Brooke. Hey! All right, Brooke. Oh, that's all right. Come on, we'll fix it. Put it in your pocket. Pick it up and put it in your pocket. I do it all the time. How are you?
How's it going?
Come on, have a seat. Well, you made it. Yeah. You made it look easy. That's why they voted you off. Are you kidding me? If I saw you, I go, I think we'll keep the heavyset guy. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, what happened?
I got blindsided, Tony. I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
I don't know. From my perspective, you know, it was a tribe of men and a tribe of women. And, you know, when you're a tribe of men, you know, the stronger guys, they're the ones who are like, you know what, we need to get rid of these guys. They're going to be threatening to us later in the game. And the thing that stunk for me was there's four young, pretty strong guys, and then there was five kind of out of shape, not very strong guys. And they just got their stuff together before we did. You know, nothing stopped me from trying to get one of those guys to form an alliance with myself.
But I saw you working. I thought you were safe for half a second, but then...
So did I.
That guy Chris, now, he couldn't get across. You know, I don't know if you saw this. The women beat the men. Not only did they beat them physically, but they beat them mentally. I mean, they beat them both ways.
Yeah, they did.
They really did. It was unbelievable.
The girls' tribe is a bunch of scrappers. They're some really, really strong girls.
They were tough. They were really tough.
I was so impressed.
And mentally tough. That's the thing. You guys couldn't make fire. Yeah. They made fire. You guys, you know, I mean, they did.
They make fire.
I think they made fire.
They won fire in the challenge.
Oh, is that what
But I was so impressed with those girls because we were going through the mud, and I'm like, oh, we're going to kill them through the mud. And I got out at the end of the mud, and the girls are screaming, come on, girls, come on. Just, you know, there's some really strong, competitive girls on that tribe.
I love competition. Well, because you made it, Brooke, let me tell you. I mean, I know you got voted off real quick, but because you is that my wife? Tell her I left, okay? because you made the challenge here, we're sending you on a 6-day Hawaiian vacation to the Ali Resort. The Ali Resort in Maui. Courtesy of our friends at resortsandlodges.com.
Awesome. Thank you.
And the audience is all going to get a Home on the Range DVD because of you as well. Brooke, that's great having you on. Okay,
thanks,
good luck.
Man.
I wish you a lot of luck.
Awesome.
Okay. Catch Survivor Thursday night at 8 p.m. on CBS, and we'll be right back. Yo, my shirt on. What a great time I had today. I hope you had fun. Say hello to Nadia Di Gelinardo. I like this job. I like it. I want to thank all my guests, Ray Romano, Rachael Ray, Ted McGinley, Brooke Garrity, and, of course, the great Erica Vetrini, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you all. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you for watching at home. I hope you come back tomorrow. Here we go. Hey. I can only give you love that will last forever. And a promise to be there each time you call. And the only heart I own for you and you alone.